We are beginning tonight with the 20th murder of the year in Salinas. And there is sad news to this very latest round of violence. Tonight's gang killing happened just 2 miles from the National Night Out event in Natividad Creek Park, where people had gathered together in the name of peace. While people were there in the park, the sound of gunshots again were heard, this time on Mazatlan and Yucatan Way at about 8 o'clock. A 17-year-old was shot several times in the head. He is dead tonight. Tonight's shooting is the fourth fatality in the last 48 hours. Last night's murder victim was a 30-year-old Arturo Marquez, gunned down on the corner of Noyce and Chaparral. Two others were shot dead on Sunday night. Action News reporter Stephanie Trong is live in Salinas, in a city that is trying to restore safety.
Yeah, Dan, it's been very crazy the last 48 hours, as you've mentioned. The 20th murder tonight, 17-year-old kid. And it's a guy that neighbors describe as a good kid who they say was athletic and who loves sports. And we're told by police tonight that he was on his way home we don't know yet where he was coming home from, but he pulled up into his driveway. And that's when there's a white truck pulled up, had at least two males inside. And at least one gunman got out of the truck, went up to him and shot him several times, multiple times. Now, witnesses say they heard 4 to 6 shots fired. One man says he was visiting next door and he rushed out when he heard the gunshots, saw the victim lying on the ground with about, he says, 4 gunshots to the head. Said, of course, there was blood everywhere, and saw the victim's sister next to him. Of course, very emotional, holding him, saying, "Brother, please stay with me." She was trying to, you know, keep him conscious and talking with her. We know, though, that the 17-year-old was taken to Natividad and was pronounced dead just minutes later. Now, as you mentioned before, this happened just 2 miles from National Night Out, and that is a community rally that was hosted by Salinas Police today to really encourage building communication between law enforcement and residents. And we had everyone from Monterey County Sheriffs to CHP to, of course, Salinas Police and Salinas Fire there, again, trying to develop relationships with the community. We spoke with Police Chief Louis Featheroff about what it will take to put a stop to these crimes.
The homicides that we're having in our community, perpetrated by a bunch of gangsters, that bunch of gangsters is a very small number and a very small part of this community. The overwhelming majority of the community needs to hold on to their community. We need not to give in to these knuckleheads and resist them and fight them and track them down and book them and arrest them and book them, do everything we possibly can. And that takes a cooperative effort.
So you see there Chief Featheroff really trying to encourage community involvement, saying that that is the final piece in what he says is the crime-fighting machine here and what it will take to stop these gang shootings. Now, police have not confirmed this, but one of the witnesses we did speak with, the one who said he described seeing the victim next door, he says he did see the gunman jump back into the white truck, which left, and says that he was able to identify one person. Again, this has not been confirmed by Salinas Police. They are not disclosing yet exactly if they've made any arrests or just how far the investigation has gone. It's still in its early stages, of course. But Dan, that is what we know so far.
All right. Thanks very much, Stephanie. And if that is indeed the case, that a witness was able to identify a gunman and that gunman was arrested, it is a rare scene in the city of Salinas and hopefully a turning point for the city that more people would come forward. With 4 killings so far, this is the second deadliest week of the year in Salinas. 5 people were killed during a real rough stretch in mid-January, and 2009 will likely be the deadliest ever on record in Salinas. The city saw 25 murders last year, that number an all-time high. Including tonight's murder, we have seen 20. We have much more on the deadly week in Salinas on our website at ksbw.com.